My research group here at Harvard is a material theory group. We think about how can we exceed the limits of optical, electronic, and thermal properties of existing materials. We think about excited state materials, we think about integrated quantum materials, and how can we make better predictions for these materials such that we could unlock applications in consumer electronics, space technologies, energy technologies, and really enable technologies of the future. My work has been entirely on the theory and computational side. I like to think of my work in materials theory as being experiments in a computer. I very often call our theory space the theory lab. I like to think that we will eventually be at a point where experiments on an optical table and experiments in a computer no longer distinguish in their outcome. So I've been interested in material science for quite some time. As an undergraduate, I was really drawn to materials because, well, everything is made of something, and if you want to make something better, you can make it with better materials. I'm interested in computational materials. That's what brought me here to Harvard. I'm interested in predicting what would materials do when they're not in their comfort zone. So if you shine a laser on a material, it's very likely that it will not act the way it was when it was not under illumination. Similarly, if the material was at a higher temperature than, say, room temperature, or certain materials even being at room temperature is an extreme environment for them. So we like to think about how do materials behave when they're far from their ground state, so in their excited state, so to speak. So when I was an undergraduate, graphene was just coming on the scene. It's literally one layer of carbon atoms, one of the lightest materials that we know of, and yet it can accomplish so much that's mechanical, that's electronic, that's optical. And I started thinking about, are there other materials that are similarly exciting and yet different in other ways? If we can make combinations of really monolayer light materials that have optical properties, we could change what we launch into space. Whether it's the next James Webb Space Telescope, whether we're thinking about initiatives like NASA's Starlight or Breakthrough Starshot, current materials will not let us get there. But monolayer or 2D materials or 2D heterostructures allow us to think about those as options for the future. So there are two areas that I think materials could really have an impact in consumer electronics. One, in changing existing consumer electronics with really ultralight materials, or materials that, say, make better displays that last 10 times as long, or batteries that last 100 times as long. We've all had phones that die on us. So it'd be great if materials could somehow allow us to address those problems. A second, and maybe a slightly orthogonal way to think about the next generation of electronics, is bringing quantum properties to bear on consumer electronics. Whether it's in the form of quantum information processing, whether it's in the form of quantum electronics, I think there's a lot to be done there. So plants, of course, are able to use sunlight, water, and CO2, all in the ambient air, and use that to create fuel, to create energy. And that's really where almost all of life gets its energy. Yet we've not been able to replicate something like that in our molecular or artificially generated molecules. And the reason for that is very simply because we don't understand some of the energy transfer mechanisms that occur in photosynthesis. When I learned about photosynthesis way back in middle school, I thought everything about photosynthesis was very clear. And then I started reading about photosynthesis some more, and I realized, wow, this is really, really poorly understood. But if we could take advantage of how excitonic transfer occurs in photosynthetic complexes, and if we could replicate that, or if we could control molecules with the same precision that nature controls molecules in leaves, we could really do some interesting work both in devices as well as in energy conversion. major component of my group is in how do we design new theoretical methods? How do we implement the equations of quantum mechanics in a manner that is computationally possible? Our unique strength is in going all the way from writing an equation, starting really from the board, all the way to implementing it in the form of a code in a computer and running it on these massively parallel computing clusters.